question. We shall go on to our next debater, Dr. K.K. Mehta on the first team. Dr. Atishwar, you're really good. Gave us a great insight about where we stand and great information.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Dr. K.K., can you share?
Share screen. Can you see
the screen? Can I see? Can you see? This is a lag.
Can you see my screen?
Yes.
You can see my screen?
Yes, we can see.
Good. Let me start off. Dr. Atishwar gave a wonderful address. And let me try and justify why I still do what I would say is about 30% of all my lenses as premium lenses in the imported category, while 60% of my lenses are still lying in the Indian category. But there's a reason why it occurs, and let me explain. Are all men created equal? The belief that everyone is created equal, that we are fundamentally the same chance to success, is fundamentally flawed. Truth is, we are not created equal. Every person has a unique set of strengths. And in a similar manner, not all IOLs are created equal. They may look the same. They may smell the same, but they're not the same. Wherein lies the difference between, let us say, a CS car and a BMW? They look almost identical, as you can see here, but there's a world of difference under the bonnet. What are we paying for when we pay the extra higher premium price? We essentially pay for the material, the proprietary research, the advances in the quality of the optics, the stability of the vision, and the long-term quality. I'd like you to come out with a basic concept. It's the painter, not the canvas of paint that matters. It's not the material or the pattern of the lens that matters. Thus, the design matters, not just the appearance and the material. Advantages of imported lenses is essentially a clearer vision, eliminate need for corrective, less distortion, less glare and flare, and a newer application of design. Designs are the same. Almost everyone has copied the same, but still, some of the original designs, which are now evolved over a period of time, are significantly better. The Lisa, for example, which is the lens I tend to use to a large extent, gives me great independence of pupil size, good light intensity, and it gives me the advantages of an enhanced contrast vision, less dazzling, and the ability to adjust your binocular vision very rapidly. Something which was shown very effectively in Atishwar's slides, that the getting it working simultaneously was great. Other thing about these lenses is what I call as a panoramic view. The periphery of the lens has a change in design. And this, especially in two of the lenses, that is in AT Lisa and the Panoptics, gives you a far better peripheral, clearer vision than it does with the Indian lenses. Halos and glare are significantly less. Most important of all, we no longer have to bother telling the patient that he will have difficulty seeing. And the better control is, most important is of what we call as chromatic aberration. When light passes through a lens, it breaks into different colors. And with a good lens system, you can focus the lens better. The material of the lens contributes to the chromatic aberration, and both the Symphony, the Panoptics, and the Zeiss are built on proprietary hydrophobic platforms, which make a difference. Again, the advantages of sterility. Preloaded lenses make loading much easier, reproducible. You can position it, especially in Tori cases, where you want it to go. And most important of all, is the stability of a toric lens. It doesn't turn. Especially the lens which I tend to use to a large extent, the Zeiss, just sticks into place. Turning is comparatively rare. So, and lack of rotation will make a toric lens much more stable. You have the advantages of utilizing the swept source system, and of utilizing a proprietary premium IOL placement. And the big advantage of utilizing these two is the combination of the software. Though all IOLs have a software to effectively contribute to toric placement, premium IOLs have their own designed software which ensures an accuracy of plus minus quarter. Though my favorite peep with all lenses is, why do you make them in half diopter steps? You should make them in quarter. So thus, reducing it down, the advantages of the premium are sharper and clearer vision, much less distortion, less glare and flare. And as I like to tell the patients, it is not a luxury, it's a necessity. If you are a working person, it makes a world of difference. Thus, though you pay a little more, you get a lot more advantages. In conclusion, they have a significantly improved post-operative visual incomes. And the newer and more advanced techniques mean that the spectacle independence, which is something you are trying to sell to the patient and for which you are charging more, is achievable, and you get better visual incomes after cataract surgery. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. KK, for your wonderful inputs. You could stop sharing your screen. So when we try to compare Indian multifocal with an important multifocal, we've all come to understand that the Indian market has really soared high. The metrics on which we measure would be, besides defocus curve, we need to look at the contrast sensitivity, the modulation transfer function, and the point spread function. So I have a question to all of you. What would be your selling point? This question is addressed to the expert panel. Anyone, you could take it. What would be your selling point when you're trying to convince a patient for an Indian multifocal against an imported multifocal? Anybody? Do you have to take specific names?
No. I try and tell the patients that you will get a good quality of vision with the Indian lens. There's no question about it. The Indian lenses have over the number of years evolved significantly, and they're pretty good. But still, it is that unnis bees farak. If you want to really get the finest clear vision, go for the imported lens. It will give that to you.
So, Dr. Chitra, I think it is really a question of a person being convinced from within. That is the ophthalmologist. By far the patient, at least in my experience, once a patient comes to you for getting a surgery done, he has innate faith in you as to what you are suggesting. So they don't really, until of course they have heard of something from some place which they have about certain lenses, there are enough Google searches and people do read about things. The only problem I would say is that India has really not come out with path-breaking technologies over the last several years because of the, you can see what the state of the medical affairs is today. And similarly, it is the same state which is there for research. So if we talk of fundamental research, Indian companies have really not done fundamental research. They are very good at doing the products which are off patent or which are now available in the market. I have personally been involved with trials which have been done for Indian companies, and I am involved with trials which are being done by FDA by foreign companies. The intensity and the tightness of the trials which are done in Indian circumstances, not for FDA US, are significantly different. So the rigorousness with which a product comes to market is very, very high when you are looking at the foreign products once they are launched in, say, US or even in Europe. The strictest, I think, is the US FDA, which is there. The problem that comes is that, for example, let us look at the aspheric technology. That never got introduced in India. It is a copy of what is there. If you look at the achromatic technology, that was not. If you look at the EDOF technology, so there are enough and more technologies. If you look at the IOL technology or even the toric, which gets approved elsewhere and then comes to India. So I would say that once there is a gap of 5-7 years between a technology that has been used elsewhere and then the As we keep on, I would say, copying those and become more and more perfect there, there is absolutely no problem. So initially, there is a hesitancy which is there. There are very few companies which invest a lot of money for Indian ophthalmologists to do research on their products and to come out with clinical impressions as to what it is. If today I have to get the outcomes, there is one large trial, say, for example, of Arvind for the toric IOLs, which is there. But if I have to do it for the other intraocular lenses that are being sold in India by Indian companies, I don't have data, comparative data, to say as to the stability of a toric IOL. Similarly, there is very little published data that is available for a lot of Indian companies. So every surgeon has to actually run it himself or herself to be convinced here that what we are putting in the patient is good. That is the only problem. If we get enough data and if we get enough people having used it and then come to the market by rigorous trials, then this problem of the confidence in a surgeon to go in for a, because when you are, because you specifically chose a topic of premium IOLs. Premium IOLs, the kind of scope for error is very little because you have to be bang on to give a bang on result. So that is the only hesitation which is there. The lathe technology or the machines, etc. now are pretty standardized of making the sterilization process, etc. But if you go to a plant, I have been to plants for manufacturing IOLs in India and I have been to plants of manufacturing IOLs overseas. I think in some plants in India, the SOPs are not fully followed. There is a difference. There are excellent plants. I have visited, say, Aurolab also. They have an excellent plant. I wouldn't name the other one where I went, where it was basically reasonably wishy-washy as regards the sterility, etc. So that is the only reason which is there. But prices-wise, yes, that is a big advantage. So it's a question of you going in with some, like Keki sir talked about, I don't know, BMW versus a Sias or whatever it is. It's a question of being having all the bells and whistles, paying a little more for it, or maybe going for something which will serve the purpose of an individual without the bells and whistle and paying less for it. So I think it's an individual thing, and it's how you feel, whether you are doing any harm to the patient by implanting the lens or not. That is your conviction which is there. So that's about it, as I would wish to say. Both have their merits to be done. But path-breaking research technology is still not there, which India is doing. India is copying technology that has been evolved overseas.
Namrata, I want to just ask you one thing. In context with my next question, you can give your answer. If a patient has significant astigmatism and he can either afford a imported hydrophobic acrylic or he can go in for an Indian toric hydrophilic, now, which would you suggest to that patient? He has significant astigmatism.
Obviously, Chitra, imported hydrophobic acrylic would be the one which I would suggest if the patient can afford it. And I think cost is an issue. Cost is an issue.
She meant whether you would choose a toric, Indian toric versus an imported monofocal, non-toric. Monofocal.
That's what I'm asking.
No. I would choose an imported toric. I would not choose an imported monofocal or Indian toric. Yeah.
No, you still...
I added a third choice to it, Chitra. I would choose an imported toric to it. I will not, choose an Indian monofocal or an imported toric or a imported Indian toric.
Gaurav?
Go in for the best only because I believe and I completely agree with Dr. Mahipal sir that there are Indian companies have not spent enough on their R&Ds. Whatever literature is available, whether it is from any institution, it is retrospective. It is not prospective and it is not multicentric. It's not involving so many centers all over the India. So we never have that robust data which we have, for the imported lenses.
Yes, that is definitely a very strong thought which has to be kept in mind. Gaurav, as you had got my question, if you were caught with a patient who can afford only this much as a package, would you suggest an imported monofocal for him or because he has significant astigmatism, would you suggest an Indian hydrophilic toric?
I do it all the time. It doesn't have to be hydrophilic Indian toric. It can be hydrophobic Indian toric as well, which I would definitely prefer. And they are very affordable. And I don't mind immediately when astigmatism is significant, I will, you know, counsel the patient and they will readily agree. And I think they do extremely well. So I used to be a doubter till a few years back about Indian IL technology. There would occasionally be refractive surprises. There would be occasional, you know, quality issues. But over the last few years, I've seen that the Indian IOLs are doing amazingly well. And I don't hesitate to use Indian lenses whenever a patient cannot afford, be it for phakic lenses, be it for torics, be it even for multifocals. You know, of course, I would not jump for a lens which was recently introduced. I'm quite careful about that. I don't like to experiment with new introduced stuff, you know, right as soon as they get launched and they ask you that, you know, you want to use this and do the trials for me. I end up being a little scared of those. But once I have enough feedback, I would not hesitate to do it. Been pretty happy with that. Of course, the bulk of my practice is still all premium imported lenses, but I don't hesitate to switch to an Indian lens whenever required.
So Chitra, just to add a little bit to it, I would rather compromise, you know, on the blades and have Indian blades and not imported blades. Would rather do Visalon rather than using Helon. But I would still counsel the patient to spend a little more to get the best lens, at least in his eye. So that is why I said I would counsel him to spend a little more and go in for an imported toric IOL.
Amrita, unfortunately, it's not a little more, it's often a lot more, you know, and it keeps the technology out of the reach of many of our patients. I do agree that, you know, innovation has not been a strong point as far as Indian companies are concerned. And I must confess that I use a lot of imported premium intraocular lenses, have been involved in multicentric trials as well as individual trials. And nowadays, we are doing it for Indian companies also in a much smaller way. But at the same time, that just because the data is not available, not using Indian lenses is something like saying that we won't use drugs off-label, you know, because the companies have not conducted enough studies. I mean, obviously, the international companies, the well-known brands that Dr. Keki was alluding to, have been approved in multiple centers across the world, in the Western world, where far more stringent criteria are there. But having said that, our Indian companies have mastered, quite a few of them, not all of them, have mastered the art of creating a good copy, and because of which it becomes affordable for our younger surgeons, the patients who cannot much more. So obviously, you know, today, multifocal intraocular lenses and toric intraocular lenses, I would not even call them premium. That's something that should be incorporated in every cataract practice. And obviously, that's something, even though we would like to offer the very best to each one of our patients, it may put it beyond the reach of many of our patients and many of the practices. The fact that we have this kind of a choice, an Indian choice, along with an imported alternative, obviously allows us to offer this advantage of these lenses to a wider spectrum of patients, carefully choosing. Having used these lenses for the last 4 or 5 years, I think in our practice, about 30-40% is Indian intraocular lenses, premium intraocular lenses. I find that these results are reasonably comparable. Even though in a very demanding patient for whom cost is not a criteria, I'll still go for an imported lens.
Thank you very much. We have more questions, but we have to move on. Our discussions have to be very brief because there are so many wonderful questions I wanted the expert panel to answer.
One second. The proof of the pudding lies that how many ophthalmologists have got Indian lenses in their own eye done? Because they come and they say,
Nepal, affordability is a criteria. Hopefully,
so that's what I said. The affordability, if you can, if it's a question of affording,
the difference is not too much, Ramamurthi, between
for example, if you take an Indian toric hydrophobic, it might be 3,000-4,000, and the other maybe 10,000 or 9,000-10,000. Yeah. So it's not something because it's a lifelong thing. So what I'm saying is that the Indian ophthalmologist who come for their own surgery to me, they actually dictate ke ye dal do sir, ya ultimately they say ke theek hai jo kuch bhi hai, we say the offer. None of them have said ke bhai mere ko ye lens dal do. Till date I have not. So that is where the proof lies as to what exactly you feel is good for your own eye. That is all that I'm trying to say. Is the situation, and even for them,
I don't think we should leave behind with an impression that
I don't think the debate can go on now because we have lost half an hour on the first topic. It has been conveyed, and I do believe that Indian multifocal do have a big role to play in our Indian market. And because we are able to reach out some multifocality to our patients, if not the most premium. Going on, I invite Dr. Harshul to go on to introduce the next team.